Night raids like this, one of the many dangers journalists are facing in Myanmar. Khong Myint Lai was live streaming for the Democratic Voice of Burma, known as DVB, when he was arrested in March. A few days earlier, he'd reported on a deadly crackdown by security forces. Since the coup on the 1st of February, more than 70 journalists have been arrested. Many independent media outlets have had their licenses revoked, including DVB. Reporters face intimidation, torture, and are in constant fear of informants turning them in. I spoke to Tan Win Tut of DVB in an undisclosed location. He escaped through ethnic rebel-held territory.
Almost all the neighborhood know you are from DVB. At the same time, you know, some informants, secret informants of the police and military and around you, you can't know who is going to inform you are here to the military.
He says he suffers from survivor's guilt. He's left, but many of his colleagues remain. The need to continue their work is paramount, he says. And he's not alone. Many other journalists have gone into hiding or fled to neighboring countries, including Thailand. But three DVB journalists and two activists were arrested in the city of Chiang Mai earlier this month for entering Thailand illegally. They said they had to escape Myanmar fearing they might be killed. They're being held in jail awaiting a trial that could lead to deportation.
So with Thailand, they have long played host to many displaced communities. And so we're really urging the Thai authorities to continue providing safety, not deport these journalists and activists or anyone really from Myanmar who is coming for safety.
The Thai Foreign Ministry has said they're concerned about the case, but they're seeking a humanitarian solution for the group of five. But it's a very delicate situation for the administration here.
Thai Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha, a former general who initially came to power through a coup, has a close relationship with Myanmar's junta leader, General Min Aung Hlaing. For the journalists still in Myanmar, they have a decision to make almost every day. Stay and continue to report, or if they have the means, go into hiding, or leave the country and continue to work in exile. Scott Heidler, Al Jazeera, Bangkok.